Kapulaan upang sa pagkakamit namin sa pangako mong bigay, kami gawin mong kasalo sa ipagkakaloob mo sa kalangitan. Sa pamagitan ni Jesucristo kasama ng Espiritu Santo, magpasawalang hanggang.
Amen. Tayo ay magsiupo. Magsiupo para sa pagpapahayag ng salita ng Diyos.
Ito na.
Pagbasa mula sa aklat ni Propeta Isaías. Sinabi ng Panginoon, ang kaniyang paghihirap ay kalooban ko. Inihandog niya ang sarili upang sa pamamagitan noon ay magkaroon ng kapatawaran. Dahil dito'y mabubuhay siya ng matagal. Makikita ang lahing susunod sa kanya. At sa pamamagitan nito niyan, may sasagawa ang aking panumpala. Pagkatapos ng pagdurusa, lalasap siya ng ligaya. Malalaman niyan, hindi nawalan ng kaguluhan ang kanyang pagtitiis. Ang aking tapat na lingkod at lubos kong kinaluludan ang siyang tatanggap sa parusa ng marami. At alang-alang sa kanya, sila'y aking patatawan. Ang salita ng Diyos.
Salamat sa Diyos.
Thank you.
Pagbasa mula sa sulat sa mga Hebreo. Mga kapatid, magpakatatag tayo sa ating pananampalataya. Yamang mayroon tayong dakilang saserdote na pumasok sa kalangitan sa harapan ng Diyos, walang iba kundi si Jesus na anak ng Diyos. Ang dakilang saserdote natin ito ay nakauunawa sa ating mga kahinaan sapagkat sa lahat ng paraan, inukso siyang tulad natin, ngunit hindi nagkasala. Kaya't huwag na tayong mag-atubiling lumapit sa trono ng mahabaging Diyos at dooy kakanta natin ang habang kalinga sa panahon kailangan natin ito. Ang salita ng Diyos.
Salamat sa Diyos.
Sabi, Guro, may hihilingin po sana kami sa inyo. Ano yon? Tanong ni Jesus. Sumagot sila, sana'y makaupo kami katabi ninyo sa inyong kaharian, isa sa kanan at isa sa kaliwa. Hindi ninyo nalalaman ang inyong hinihingi, sabi ni Jesus sa kanila. Mababatakan ninyo ang hirap na babatahin ko. Pabibinyag pa kayo sa binyag na daranasin ko? Opo, tugon nila. Sinabi ni Jesus, ang hirap na babatahin ko ay babatahin nga ninyo at kayo'y bibinyagan sa binyag na daranasin ko. Ngunit wala sa akin ang pagpapasya kung sino ang mauupo sa aking kanan at sa aking kaliwa. Ang mga luklukang sinasabi ninyo ay para sa mga pinanghandaan. Nang marinig ito ng 10 alagad, nagalit sila sa magkapatid. Kaya't pinalapit sila ni Jesus at sinabi, alam ninyo na ang mga itinuturing na pinuno ng mga hintil ay siyang pinapanginoon at ang mga dinadakila ay siyang nasusunod. Ngunit hindi ganyan ang dapat umirag sa inyo. Sa halip, ang sino man sa inyo na ibig maging dakila ay dapat maging lingkod. At sino mang ibig maging pinuno ay dapat maging alipin ng lahat. Sapagkat ang anak ng tao ay naparito hindi upang paglingkuran, kundi upang maglingkod at ibigay ang kanyang buhay sa ikatutuos ng lahat. Mga kapatid, ang mabuting balita ng ating Panginoon.
We thank God for all the blessings He has given us, especially the Kilchum, the Filipino community here in Kilburn. The theme of our gospel is Jesus came to serve and not to be served. This is the motto of the oblates of Mary Immaculate, like Saint Alphonsus, Saint Eugene had a vision to serve and preach the gospel to the poor. And if you see or read the history of England after the emancipation, there were many Catholics in UK migrating from Ireland and other parts of the world. I think the OMI in Ireland sent their missionaries here in UK, especially to serve the Irish. And he said this area of Kilburn were populated by Irish people. And you know, at the time, many of you Irish here, they came here to work before the war and after the war. And many of them came from poverty. And not only that, they were discriminated here in UK in many parts. You see, many of them came looking for a place to stay. And people would post, no blacks, no Irish, and no dogs. Is that true? Are you Irish, Father? Yeah. There's great discrimination of that. No? And the OMI served them, a lot of them, workers in the docks. We have the Tower Hill people, and here many of those who did the railways in UK mostly were done by Irish laborers. But now the Irish are no longer poor, no? Even in Ireland, the Celtic economy. But sad to say, when you become rich or better, you lose your faith, no? But who are the poor now here in UK and Europe? They are the migrants. They are the migrants from Philippines, from Asia, from Africa, and so on. And the OMI continues to serve them. And when about a dozen of Filipinos discerned that they would separate from a bigger group to adapt to a parish, it was the later, is it Remy, no? Remy Villacruz, Sister Hankam, Lolit Hankam, and Arnel and Susan. I remember that, no? Because I used to be chaplain of Filipinos here during the time of Ambassador Bautista and Ambassador Espiritu. And they were very great, you know, in helping the poor Filipinos, especially those undocumented domestic helpers coming from the Middle East, who were abused by the employers, and later on nurses who came here to work as nurses but ended up in caring homes and were abused in the caring homes. Ambassador Bautista and myself and Mario de Leon had to go around UK to help these people. So these are the ministry that we are called to serve and not be served. Because some people would like to become priests in order to have best clothes and so on, you know. That is not the missionary spirit of the OMI and other missionary priests. This is very important for us to come into history as these 12 people who started the Philchamp, as they asked me, you know, they said they want to serve a church. I said, better look for a church. And then they came here in Kilburn. It was Father Ray Warren. You remember Father Ray Warren? He accepted them, no? And now you grew up, And I, my priest, are very fond with the Filipinos. Especially the last priest, he was Terry Mori, no? I knew Terry Mori because he used to invite them in a pub, no? He likes to be people in the pub, you know, and the Filipinos. He's a very jolly priest, but he died, no? Was it last year he died? And so we pray that this mission of Kilburn Secular Church with the ONI may continue not only to Filipinos, but also to other people, especially to migrants. And as I go around, I encourage Filipinos not just to have Filipino cliques, no? To integrate themselves in the parish. And here in Kilburn, the Filipinos are integrated in the parish, no? Some of them are even members of the PCC, no? And the sacristan and so on, no? This is our mission, according to Pope Francis. We are the smugglers of faith. And Cardinal Tagle is also the mission for evangelization. The Filipinos are in different countries, not only to earn pounds of money, but to share our faith. Last month, I was invited to a house blessing. The Irish family with an Ilongga domestic helper. And the Irish lady said, "Father, I'm very, very, I'm a Catholic, you know? And I'm very, very guilty because I always work for money. But I have my domestic helper here. I thank her because she taught them the Catholic faith, no? And even the little boy can pray the Our Father in Ilonggo, no? And there are boys from Eton, no? Well-to-do family, and with the domestic helpers caring for them, evangelizing the families here, not only rich people, but other communities as well. Because there is hunger of faith and morality in this country. In the parliament now, they are talking about assisted suicide. You know what is assisted suicide? Injection na ka lang, matanda ka na para mamatay, no? Para walang gasto ng assisted suicide, no? So, it's very, very... In the Philippines, there's no... Even abortion is very difficult, you know, although there are some cases, you know. But here it's rampart, no? In the Philippines, not much of divorce, you know. We still hold on to family values. Of course, there are other exceptions, you know. It's more exceptions than a rule, no? But here the exception are the rule now, no? In this society where faith is taken for granted, where money is more important than our love and fear of one another and of God. So my dear brothers and sisters, as we thank God for the 20th celebration of the Kilchum and other Filipino communities all over the parishes and dioceses. I am in Oxfordshire. We have also Filipinos there, no? It's a countryside. I thought there were no Filipinos there, you know? Because I have 20,000 in my flock. There are sheep and pigs. There are farms, you know? But in the farms, there are Filipinos also, right? May mga Filipino tayo, mga butchers na, right? Mga assistant agriculturist, no? Nagbabantay, nagpapakain ng baboy at baka, no? And they are spreading the faith there, no? We have Bible sharings with them and a mass in farm areas. So let us continue our mission here, not only for Filipinos, but for one another, and bring about the true culture of the Filipinos. Maki Diyos, maki tao, maki pamilya,
makibayan. Amen.
Amen.
Tayo po ay tumayo para sa ating sumasampalataya. Sumasampalataya ako sa Diyos Amang makapangyarihan sa lahat na may gawa ng langit at lupa. Sumasampalataya ako kay Kristo, isang anak ng Diyos, Panginoon natin lahat. Pagkatawang tao siya na lang ng Espiritu Santo. Ipinanas si Santa Maria Belen. Pinakapasakit ni Poncio Pilato. Ipinako sa krus na matay inilibing. Nanaw sa pinaroonan ng mga yumao. Nang pagkatumaraw, buhay na buhay na maguli. Umakyat sa langit, natulog sa kanan ng Allah ang kapangyarihan sa lahat. Doon nagmumulang palilito at hukong sa nangabuhay at namamatay na tao. Sumasampalataya naman ako sa Diyos Espiritu Santo, sa banal na simbahang Katolika, sa kasamaan ng mga banal, sa kapatawaran ng mga kasalanan, sa pagkabuhay muli ng mga matay na tao at sa buhay na walang hanggan.
Sa araw nito, Linggo ng Misyon, pangdigdig, alalahanin natin ang lahat ng ating kapatid sa larangan ng misyon at ipahayag natin ang ating pakikisa sa kanila sa pamamagitan ng ating matayong team na kahilingan.
Ang ating po itutugon, Panginoon, dinggin mo kami. Para sa simbahan Katolika at mga namumuno rito, naway hindi nila kaligtaan ang kanilang bukasyon na mangaral ng Ebanghelyo sa lahat ng bansa. Manalangin tayo.
Panginoon,
para sa lahat ng mga relihiyoso at laikong hinirang ng Diyos upang maging misyonaryo, naway tugunan nila ang kanilang bukasyon na may buong katapatan, manalangin tayo.
Panginoon, dinggin mo kami.
Para sa lahat ng misyonaryo, naway kantimpalaan ng Panginoon ang kanilang dedikasyon sa paghahatid ng liwanag ng mabuting balita sa lahat sa pamamagitan ng masugid na pangangaral at pagpupunyagi sa mabuting gawa, manalangin tayo.
Panginoon, dinggin mo kami.
Para sa lahat ng mga pinuno ng ating pamahalaan, naway mapagtanto nila na kasama ng kapangyarihan ang responsibilidad na maglingkod sa bayan ng buong katapatan at walang paghahanap sa sariling kapakanan lamang, manalangin tayo. Para sa ating parokya, naway tayo ay maging isang tunay na mapag-arugang sambayanan na handang magbigay saksi sa pag-ibig ng Diyos sa pamamagitan ng pagbabahagi ng ating pananampalataya at pagtulong sa ating kapwa, manalangin tayo. Para sa ating lahat, naway hindi tayo maghangad ng katungkulan upang magtamo ng karangalan, kundi upang higit na makapaglingkod sa ating mga kapatid ng buong kababaan loob at kabukasang palad, manalangin tayo.
Panginoon,
let us spend silence for our personal intentions and those of us for prayers. And we say all this to the session of our Blessed Lady as we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now at the hour of our death. Amen. All this we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pepe Magsiro po para sa ating pag-aalay.
Stretch out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to wave the crowns of
manifest the resurrection. And so with all the angels and all the saints, we declare your glorious one voice, we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Thank you.
Pinilin namin kami at Joshua na masama. Pagkalagaban kami apat araw-araw, iligtas sa kasalanan at ilayo sa lahat ng kapamakan. Samantalang aking pinananabikan ang nagilang araw ng pagpapahayag ng tagapagligtas namin si Jesus Cristo.
Thank you.
Manalangin tayo. Ama namin mga pagmahal, sa aming banal na mag-inabang ay magdulot-lawa ng kagalingan ng aming katapuan upang kami makatambal sa luwalhatian ng aming nalalakukan sa tiniis na kamatayan sa aming ngayon ipinahayag sa ginanap na pagdiriwa sa pamagitan ni Kristo kasama ng Espiritu Santo magpasawalang hanggan.
Amen!
Tayo po muna ay magsiupo bago ang ating final blessing. So, ang una po ay yung mga bata po pwedeng ihanda ng mga ushers dahil po ngayon ay 1 ng Oktubre. It is the month of our Blessed Mother. So, the children, please prepare them so that they may have to offer flowers. So, when they are doing that, Father Tom would like to give us a message. He gave us a message a while ago, but he would like to add more. So, Father Tom.
I'd like to send greetings to you. Especially he's come from now to start the day. Partly because he's going to Belgium tomorrow for a priest receiving a doctorate. So what's that? But I'm visiting Father Carlo's words, which I thank you very much for. I used to say to Father Terry, Filipinos are the new Irish. But thankfully, you don't see any signs up on the windows. So, delighted to have you here. Delighted you're able to celebrate with us and to be able to continue the celebrations now in our parish hall. Thanks, everybody.
Thank you, Father, for inspiring the Filipino community so that we can give more. Thank you, Father. So may we now have the flower offering.
Oh,
blessing, such a nice one for our Blessed Mother. So may I call now Nilda Banapo to introduce our guest speaker for today in celebration for our 20th anniversary.
Magpapalang hapon po sa lahat. Isang karangalan po na ipakilala ko sa ating lahat ang ating Philippine Ambassador to UK, His Excellency Teodoro Luxin Jr.
Father Claro, Condim, Father Tom Dabrow, Father Irvin Amarasteel, Father Johnson, Father Ilango, officers and members of PhilCham, ladies and gentlemen. First, let me thank you, Father, for your important sermon on migrants who come to serve their fellow men and fellow women, especially the butchers, farmers, and seasonal fishermen. I mentioned the butchers because I've gotten complaints from the Philippines that the butchers are all here. Frankly, I don't know what the butchers really do. I thought they just chop up the cow. But apparently, it's an art. And when they complained, I said, well, if you treated our butchers better at home, perhaps they will all be in the UK. As I mentioned, the seasonal farmers and fishermen who feed their hosts here in the UK. One day, Father, when you gather them, please tell me. I will be so honored to join you. Good afternoon. What a joy it is to be here with you today as we celebrate the 20th anniversary of PhilCham. This year's theme, Remembering the Past with Gratitude, Living the Present in Faith, Moving Forward in Hope, perfectly captures the heart of this celebration. It reflects not only the journey of PhilCham over the past two decades, but also the shared story of the Filipino community and the United Kingdom. Let me begin by remembering the past with gratitude. We take this moment to honor the founders of PhilCham, whose vision and dedication gave birth to this organization. Through their hard work and the support of dedicated volunteers, PhilCham has grown into the strong and dynamic community it is today. To those who have led and served PhilCham over the years, please take a bow and give yourselves a round of applause. You have laid a deep foundation of camaraderie, trust, and service that has uplifted Filipinos in the UK and back home. As we reflect on the past, we express our gratitude to the many individuals, families, and organizations that have supported PhilCham's mission. Whether through financial contributions, time, or just being present, their collective efforts have made a tremendous impact. It is your generosity that's allowed PhilCham to extend a helping hand to those in need, promote our rich Filipino culture, and create a sense of belonging here in the UK for so many of our Kababayans. But today is also about living the present in faith. In these challenging times, faith has given strength to many of us. Faith not only in our spirituality, but also in the community we have built here. As we navigate the uncertainties of the world, PhilCHAMP stands as a pillar of hope and support, helping us stay connected, resilient, and focused on what truly matters. And as we celebrate this milestone, we also move forward in hope. The future is filled with good possibilities. I'm confident that PhilCHAMP will continue growing, evolving, and inspiring. We move forward knowing that PhilCHAMP will stay a solid anchor of our community. On behalf of the Philippine Embassy, I extend my warmest congratulations to PhilCHAMP on your 20th anniversary. You have been a vital part of the Filipino presence in the UK. We are proud of you, of all of you, of all that you have achieved. May you continue to inspire, uplift, and serve our Kababayans for many more years to come. Remember, we are always stronger together. Father Tom, I'm proud to say I'm Irish. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Filipinos and Irish together. So thank you very much, our dear Impact Ambassador, for the inspirational, inspiring, and uplifting message. Celebration. So we hope next year again. Thank yeah. you. So may we now call on the PPC president, Mary Ryan is our the president of the parish council. So we are under the parish, so we are under the PPC. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. As chair of the parish council, it's a great honour to come here today and congratulate PhilCHAMP on their 20th anniversary, because as His Excellency has said, PhilCHAMP, you're a great community and support for each other, but you reach out to other Filipino communities when you see need, and you're a great community embedded in our parish now. You do so much in the liturgy for the musicians and the choir and anything that needs to be done. You're a great part of our parish and we thank you. You bring great joy as well. You know, you pray well and you celebrate well, and it's a great joy to share it with you. So congratulations, and we look forward to 20 more years of you here with us.
So thank you, Sister Mary Ryan, for the message. Before I call on the birthday and anniversary celebrants, may I just give an announcement that after our Mass, everybody is invited to join the program next door, Pasinod Hall. So you just go outside and then go to the next door. So we'll be having program and we'll be having dinner. Yeah, so everybody's invited. Please join us for our 20th anniversary program. So may I now call on the Octoberian birthday celebrants, and those are celebrating their anniversaries, to please come forward so you'll be able to receive more blessings. So Octoberian celebrants and those who are celebrating their anniversaries.
Okay.
So you please face the front first, and then after the blessing, you can face the back. Okay.
Thank you. Thank you.